Welcome to Front Porch Lawyer, where we address the humanity of lawyering. Many attorneys are winning battles in the courtroom, but losing battles in their lives. From interpersonal relationships to stress management, Front Porch Lawyer explores topics that improve your practice, your lifestyle, and even your love life. Leave feeling a little more inspired with a smile on your face. Here's your host, Francine Tone.
Imagine a woman comes into your office and says she wants to get a divorce after 14 years of marriage. She tells you that she signed a prenuptial agreement, and the prenuptial agreement says that if she had an affair, she gets nothing from her very wealthy husband. And of course, she had an affair. Well, as you've developed your relationship with the client, eventually she tells you, I want to get on the stand and I'm willing to lie in order to win. Now you have a dilemma. The dilemma is you must tell her, I can't put you on the stand, the legal system doesn't allow for this. But now you've got this relationship with your client and it might sound like you're backing off of representing her, that maybe you're saying you can't because you're not willing or not competent, but you're not on her team anymore. That's how you can come across to your client. So how do you deal with this without losing sleep, without causing that trust that you've spent so hard to create being jeopardized? Hi, welcome to Front Porch Lawyer, where we explore the humanity and the emotional intelligence of lawyering. I'm Francine Tone, your host. A while back, I gave a continuing legal education course on developing and creating that client trust and not letting it fall apart because something goes wrong in the case. And at the end of the course, one of the questions that came up was exactly this. What do you do when you have to tell the client something that is negative, and basically you're telling the client, I can't do what you want, because you might look weak when you do that, or maybe they start not trusting you, whatever the reason. So I have a really simple solution for this, and that is to remove yourself from the equation, and let me explain. When you have to tell the client directly this information, it will look like you're either weak or you're backing off, you can't be their zealous advocate, you're not on their team anymore. But you know all you're doing is trying to share generic, not case-specific information. So by removing yourself, you put the information somewhere outside of you. What I've done in my practice is I've put it in a book. I put a lot of generic information in my book, which is what every good lawyer wants you to know. And I just give this to my clients. Now you may not have a book, you could put it in a handout, or have another lawyer in your office have this conversation with your client, because that lawyer is not the person that this client has developed this massive trust with. And you can do it together with the client. You sit on the same side of the table with the client and have the lawyer that's going to explain this sit on the other side, so that you are sitting on the same side with your client as part of his or her team. But however way you do it is get yourself out of the equation, pull yourself out as the messenger of the bad news. So, did you recognize the fact pattern that I use? It comes from the movie Liar Liar. So, remove yourself from the equation and send me your comments or comment below. Send me your emails about anything that I've done in Front Porch Lawyer. And I want to thank you for hanging out with me on my front porch. This is Francine Tone and Front Porch Lawyer, and I'll see you next time.